We want a CLICK PLC to talk to a GS4 drive over Modbus TCP. To do that, you need to have a CLICK PLC with an Ethernet port, of course, and connect it and your GS4 drive to your Ethernet network. You'll need the GS4's optional COM card to communicate via Modbus TCP. I'm using a little test network in my office with these IP addresses. Yours will probably have different IP addresses. In the CLICK software, let's have the rising edge of contact C1 send a frequency command. We want port 1, which is the Ethernet port on a CLICK, and Modbus protocol. Let's set up the CLICK's Ethernet port. We want to set the IP address to be compatible with our network, so I'll give it this address, mask, and gateway that we had on that previous diagram. The rest of this is fine, so hit OK. Enter the IP address of the GS4 drive that we saw on that network diagram just a minute ago here. The GS4 drive's ID is a 1. We want to write a single register using Modbus. And if we look at the GS4 manual, we see these are the addresses we need to control the GS4 drive. Frequency is at this address, so we put that here. Notice that the CLICK uses a 40 here instead of the 4 shown in the GS4 user manual. That's important, don't miss that. And we'll put the frequency value to send in this register. I'll fill out the status data just in case we get an error. Perfect. Well, that set up the frequency command. I'm just going to copy that rung, paste it, and let's have C2 send a run command. The GS4 manual tells me that's at this address, and we have to add the 40 for the CLICK. And we'll use register DS2 to hold the run command, which we'll set to a 2 in the data view in just a minute. Copy that rung and paste it, and we'll have C3 be the stop command. It's identical, except it sends a 1, which we'll store in DS3. Copy that rung, paste it, and let's have C4 send the forward command. That's at the same Modbus address, and we'll put the forward command in DS4. Copy that, paste it, let's have C5 send the reverse command, which uses the same address, but we'll send the contents of DS5, which will be a 32. And don't forget the end instruction. Great, let's write that to the PLC. I've already created a data view with all the control bits, created nicknames for all those, and I put the values we need for the various commands in the DS registers. And let's put a frequency of 33 Hz in here. I've already set up the GS4 to accept Modbus TCP commands using this video. So let's try it. Make sure the CLICK is in run mode. And if we toggle C1 to change the frequency, sure enough, the drive responds. If I toggle C5 to change to reverse, yep, drive got it. If I toggle the run bit, the drive starts spinning. Toggle the forward bit, and it starts to change direction. And toggle the stop, and the drive ramps to a stop. Well, that ought to be enough to get you started. CLICK here to learn more about the GS4 drive. CLICK here to learn about Automation Direct's free support options. And CLICK here to subscribe to Automation Direct's YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.